Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to perform basic lab of VPC. In this lab I have created a custom VPC. In custom VPC I will create two subnet, one for public subnet and second for private subnet. We have assigned the subnet mask for VPC 172.16.0.0/16, and for public subnet we will assign 172.16.1.0/24 CIDR value, and for private subnet we will assign for 172.16.2.0/24 subnet. After that we will create the routing table separately for both subnet, public subnet and private subnet. And after that we will create two EC2 instance, Linux based two EC2 instance, one for public subnet and one for private subnet. Public subnet directly access the internet because it is having on the public subnet, and the private subnet did not directly access the internet. So let's perform this lab. So friend, now I have logged in my AWS console. So firstly go to VPC. In VPC, click your VPC. If you created any custom VPC, it listed over here. Right now it is showing the default VPC. So now we are going to create custom VPC. So for creating the custom VPC, click create VPC, assign the name demo VPC, and the CIDR value is 172.16.0.0/16. Click no IP CIDR block and click create VPC. The first step is firstly create your custom VPC and assign the CIDR value of your VPC. Again click on your VPC. So demo VPC is created and the CIDR value is 172.16.0.0/16. Now we go for create two subnet, one for public subnet and second for private subnet. Just click on subnet icon. The three subnet is listed over here. These all are default subnet. So create new subnet. Select VPC ID, select your demo VPC, name of the subnet, demo public subnet, availability zone. You can select your availability zone. I have selected AP South 1A. And the CIDR value is 172.16.1.0/24 and click create subnet. So our public demo public subnet is created. Now again click create subnet. For creating private subnet, select the CIDR, select the VPC, demo VPC and name private subnet, demo private subnet, availability zone. I have select the availability zone AP South 1B and the CIDR value is 172.16.2.0/24 and click create subnet. So friends, I have created a VPC, demo VPC, and assigned the CIDR value with the mentioned 172.16.0.0/16 and create two subnet, public subnet and private subnet. Public subnet we have assigned 172.16.1.0/24 CIDR value, and for private subnet we have assigned 172.16.2.0 CIDR value. Now we go for create two route table for one for public subnet and one for private subnet. So just click on route table. It is a basically default route table, and it is a your demo VPC main table. It is a default VPC table, root table, and it is your created custom demo VPC main table. So I did not change any both of these table. I will create the separately two other table. For creating the root table, just click create root table, name demo public root table. In VPC, select your demo VPC, click create, click close. So demo public root table is created. It is not a main root table, it is a custom root table. Again click create root table, assign the name demo private root table, select your VPC, demo VPC, and click create, click close. So both public and private root table is created, and both are not a main root table, though both are custom root table. So friends, now we have go for assign the subnet. Means in a public root table we have assigned public subnet, and in a private root table we have assigned the private subnet. So click on public root table and click subnet association. In subnet association you listed both of the subnet, public subnet and private subnet. So friends, click edit subnet association and select your public, select your public subnet which is assigned 172.16.1.0/24 CIDR value, and click save. Same as it is, go on private root table and subnet association tab, click edit subnet association and select your private subnet, click save. So friends, now we have created our custom VPC, and we have created the two different subnet, public subnet and private subnet. After that we have created the two root table for both public subnet and private subnet, and associate the subnet. In public root table we have associate public subnet CIDR value. In private root table we have associated the private subnet CIDR value. Now friends, we go for create two EC2 instance, one EC2 instance in our public subnet and one EC2 instance in our private subnet. So click on services and click EC2. Click on instances. Launch instances. Select Amazon Linux 2 AMI select T2 micro, click next. Now here we have select VPC to our demo VPC, and subnet is our public subnet, and auto assign public IP click enable. The three major point you have to notice: in network we have select your custom VPC, in subnet you have select your public subnet, and auto assign public IP you have select enable option, which you want to allow IP public IP on your EC2 instance. Click next. Next for security group. The SSH port is allowed, and we have also enabled one more port, which is TCP ICMP version 4 for all public IP. And click review and launch. Click launch and select your key pair and click launch instance. So friend, we have launched our one EC2 instance in public subnet, and now we go for launch our second EC2 instance in private subnet to go again EC2. Click instances. Firstly, we have assigned its name. Public EC2. Launch instances. Linux 2 AMI. T2 micro. In network we have select the demo VPC. In subnet we have select demo private subnet. And auto assign public IP, we don't need to assign a public IP to our private subnet EC2 instance. So click disable. Next. SS for enable all public IP. We don't need to enable all public IP because there's no internet connection on these instances. We have allow /16 VPC ID, VPCC ID value. Click review and launch and click launch. Select acknowledge for key pair and click launch instance. So friends, we have launched two instances. One instances for public subnet and one instances in private subnet. In public subnet instances, we have assigned public IP, and private subnet instance we don't need to assign a public IP because we don't want to connect our private subnet instance to have the connection between from internet. So let's check our EC2 instance is working and up. So friends, our public EC2 instance is ready, status 2x2 check is okay. So just click on public EC2 instance and here you show that its public IP is 172.161.147 and is also assigned its private IP is 172.161.147 and it also assigned a public IP which is 13.232.172.244. Means we can connect this EC2 instance from internet. So let's connect SSH to this public EC2 instance. So just copy public IP and open the PuTTY session, paste here the IP and click on SSH, click auth and select your PPK file and click open. Oh, I am not able to connect internet I am not able to connect SSH yet because I am not even create a internet gateway. So if you assign a public IP of your EC2 instance, but until you not created the internet gateway, you not able to connect your EC2 instance or your EC2 instance not able to connect on internet. So in this figure, now we need to create a internet gateway and assign to in VPC. So you can create only one internet gateway on your VPC. In default VPC, it already created and attached to your default VPC. So now go again on VPC. Click on Internet Gateway. It is a default VPC for default. Internet gateway for default VPC. So you have to create new VPC and attach to your VPC to assign the name. So name it demo internet gateway. Click create internet gateway. Okay. Now I want to try again. Again open PuTTY session and paste the public IP and select your PPK file, private key file, and click open. We are not able to connect SSH yet because we have created the internet gateway, but we have not assigned it to VPC. So firstly we go for assign our internet gateway to our VPC. So click on internet gateway, select your demo internet gateway and click on action and attach to VPC, select your demo VPC and click attach internet gateway. Okay, now again we have to connect our PuTTY session to our Linux EC2 instance which is on public subnet. Still we are not able to connect our PuTTY session because we have created the internet gateway, we have associated to our VPC, but we did not still define the path on our root table how to reach the internet gateway. So you need to assign the path on your root table how your EC2 instance go to the internet gateway. So just define the path on your public root table ki how your EC2 instance go to the internet gateway. After that your EC2 instance can communicate to the www or internet. So just click on root table click your public root table, go to roots. Here only one roots is applicable available, which is 172.16.0.0/16. मतलब whole VPC CIDR value target means local, means is communicate as a locally, means as a local area internet, and except from these IPs there is no any path available on the root table. So click on edit roots, add root, and assign 0.0.0. means any of IP except from mentioned IP address, means 172.16.0.0. if any IP request is come, then send that request to internet gateway, which is demo internet gateway, and click save root. Now again we try to connect our Linux EC2 instance, which is having on public subnet. Just try to connect again. Now we are able to connect our EC2 instance because we have created the internet gateway, we have attached internet gateway to our VPC, and also defined the path in our root table for internet gateway. So click yes, type EC2 user. So friends, we have successfully connected our EC2 instance, and its IP, its private IP is 172.161.147. And friends, if I go to again EC2, click instances, and click public EC2. So it's public EC2 instance, private IP is 172.16.1.147. So its private IP is 172.16.1.147. So we are able to connect our Linux EC2 instance, which is having on public subnet. Now if we want to connect our private EC2 instance, so click on private EC2 instance, so and go to the detail option. So its IP, private IP is 172.162.192, and its public IP, we don't need to assign public IP to this private instance, so it's not having any public IP. So friends, now question is raised, how we can connect our private EC2 instance? So answer is, through our public EC2 instance. Firstly, we need to connect our public EC2 instance, and after that, from public EC2 instance, we have connect our private EC2 instance. So friends, our private EC2 instance IP is 172.16.2.192. So we have connect our private EC2 instance from our public subnet, yeah, public EC2 instance. So from SSH we need to require PEM file, which is downloaded while we creating the EC2 instance. So just create a PEM file, and to type nano, we create the PEM file in temp location, and the file name is key.pem, and just copy the content of your PEM file which downloaded while you creating the EC2 instance. Just control A, control C, and paste here. Save this file, control O, enter, control X. Now assign the security assign the permission, assign the permission of that PEM file. Now try to connect your private EC2 instance private IP with the help of SSH. The IP is 172.168.2.19194. Just cross check the IP 192.168.2.192. Just press enter, click yes. So friends, now we have connect our private EC2 instance, which IP is 172.168.2.192. So this is a procedure how you can create the your custom VPC. After that, you need to create subnet. After that, you have to create root table. After that, you need to create internet gateway and assign to the VPC and define the path to internet gateway on your public root table. This is a procedure of the create the default create the custom VPC. And if you want to connect your private subnet EC2 instance, then you need to connect to your public EC2 instance. From public EC2 instance, you can connect your private EC2 instance, which is located on your private subnet. So friends, thank you for watching. Thank you. Bye.